Hey, Gene Borrello, you have these channels doing your dirty work, attacking me, calling me a snitch and stuff, and you're trying to say some of the stuff that I put up yesterday on you was not true. So let's clear this up right now. Okay, those shows attacking me, they can attack me, they can say whatever they want, they can talk about warrants and all that stuff. But here's the reality, Gene. Jerry Capeci did a story on you, much more in depth than mine, and he did a very good job. And so you have to understand that this was going to be out there whether I reported it or not. So basically, what you need to do is man up and accept the fact that you're doing these things, Gene. And I'm just going to go over this quick. This is a quick video, people. But Gene Borrello is out there right now on Instagram last night. He promoted someone's show that was attacking me, calling me a snitch for actually doing this story on him. So, Gene, let's make this story a little bit clear. If you want to provoke me and take me on, I'm more than willing to do it, Gene. Because now you have people attacking me on your behalf because they think you're famous or something. So let's clear this up right now. Okay, here's what Capeci says. Cowboys and their Monday football. Oh, by the way, Jerry Capeci has Gangland, Gangland, a great site to read stories on. Please go over there. And for $5 a month, you could literally read so much stuff that he has. It's like an encyclopedia of the mob stuff. And it's not like other people's mob stuff. It's actually really good stuff. And he writes his own stuff. He doesn't use Wikipedia stuff like a lot of shows around here do. Jerry Capeci is he's at the top of his game. Let's put it that way. And this is his article right here. And I hope he's okay with me using it. But I would say, please, for $5 a month, you can go to him and join up on Gangland, and these are the type of stories you get that I'm about to read to you. And it says, Cowboys, Gene Borrello braves strep throat and Tampa Bay fans to root for Cowboys in their Monday night football win over Buccaneers. Feds tell judge to lock them up for 3 years. So what happened there is, Gene, it was you that went and you went to the game. After you told them that you had a strep throat and you could not show up, you didn't present the right medical records to the courts. And then you did a video within hours of you at the Tampa Bay game not looking like you had a strep throat. So you lied to the courts, not me. I just reported what's here. That's my job. Okay, you could try to turn this on me, Gene, but this is not about me. This is about you doing these things. Gene Borrello, the hot-headed gangster, ex-gangster turned informer turned podcaster from Howard Beach, seems to have zero credibility left with the feds. The former cooperating witness was seen and heard on Instagram, proudly cheering on the Dallas Cowboys on their Monday night football win. Even though he claimed he had a bad case of strep throat, got him a postponement for his sentence hearings. The feds suspect he lied about getting the strep throat. Worse, they now describe him as a certified danger to the community and who should be put back behind bars. Federal prosecutors had previously sought just 8 months for Borrello's second violation of a violation of probation. But in a fairly stunning move, the feds yesterday asked the Brooklyn judge, Frederick Block, to give Borrello 3 years, 3 more years for the violation of probation. They also asked Block to conduct a hearing and impose more time besides the 3 years, Gene. Okay. And conduct a hearing, impose more time behind bars for a slew of lies and crimes that Borrello has committed in the past year. So you can blame me, Gene, but I'm not here committing these crimes with you. He is in danger to the community, wrote federal prosecutor Matthew Galeotti, noting that Borrello obtained permission to move to Florida by making false statements to the court. Since then, Borrello's conduct has become increasingly aggressive and dangerous, wrote Galati. The defendant has breached the court's trust over and over again. Borrello has had a tough time in the Sunshine State since his arrival. He has been arrested twice for domestic abuse involving his then-girlfriend, who has given an order of protection after Borrello allegedly manhandled her and took her cell phone and smashed it to the ground and stomped on it. Borrello also threatened to kill a second victim, a bartender, Galati added. In this memo, the prosecutor stated that Borrello had gotten an unidentified cohort to visit the lounge where the bartender worked, lift up his shirt and reveal something black in his waistband and tell him you're fucking dead. That's not all. Borrello also arrested last month on burglary charges, the prosecutor stated, and he was again arrested in Pinellas County Police Department for stalking last week. Last week, Gene. On January 11th. Today is January 20th. So whose fault is that, Jane? This was just one day before his lawyer, Nancy Ennis, emailed the court and obtained an adjournment of his sentencing, stating her client had contacted strep throat. In this filing, Galati questioned the veracity of that diagnosis. And asked Block to order Borrello to furnish medical records to confirm that assertion and sentence him to 3 years on February 8th. If Borrello had strep throat on January 12th, he could have easily recovered in time for the 8:15 kickoff for the grid iron battle between the Cowboys and the Buccaneers. That's fact. But you didn't send medical records to them. That's the issue they have, Gene. And this is the Fed saying this. This is Jerry Capeci saying this. This ain't Lee Cole saying it, Gene. Okay. In his social media account, Borrello seemed pretty chippy. I'm a Cowboy fan, but I'm going to the game tonight, Borrello said, grinning under a Bucks hat, where he was wearing what he was wearing on his way to the game. He said he was pretending to be rooting for Tom Brady and the Bucks, because if someone throws something at me in the stands, you know I'm going to go crazy, he said, referring to his often admitted propensity for violent explosions, verbal and otherwise. So I'll be pretending, go Bucks, but inside it'd be no, go Cowboys, Borrello continued, repeating later, just in case some of the Instagram's followers didn't get his drift, I got a Bucks hat on, but I'm really a Cowboys fan. That sounds like you're playing both sides of the fence, Gene, and whoever was winning is who you would have been cheering for. And a later posting, while sitting at the Tampa Bay's game in Raymond James Stadium, who were watching their beloved Bucks get trounced by the Cowboys, he couldn't control himself and started shouting, "Let's go, Cowboys." So, Gene, if you were really concerned about someone throwing something at you, why were you chanting, "Let's go, Cowboys," at the game? Borrello moved to Florida in July after Judge Block postponed his hearing for 3 months and let him move after defense lawyer Ennis filed a phony-looking letter stating that Borrello had been offered a job as a roofer, and that turned out to be a complete fabrication, according to the owner of the roofing company, Robin Shearer of TG Roofing of Oldsmar, Florida. "We did not offer this guy a job," Shear told Gangland last year. And when he was asked about the unsigned, undated letter, noted that it contained much more bogus info about his company. Shear said that he had never written a letter like this and that no one from my company wrote this. So right away, Gene, as soon as you went down to Florida, you started lying right away, dude. And Judge Block just gave you the opportunity to get your life together. "We did not offer this guy a job," Shear told Gangland last year. He said last year, "We did not offer this guy a job" about the unsigned, undated letter. So not only did you give him a letter, Gene, it was unsigned and undated. Come on, you could have done better than that. Noting that it contained much bogus info about his company, Scheer said that he had never written a letter like this and that no one from the company wrote this. In last year's ruling, Block indicated that he intended to give Borrello a no jail sentence. Think about this. And this is important, Gene, and to people watching this. Okay. In last year's ruling, Judge Block indicated that he intended to give Borrello a no jail sentence if his new gig and his new digs in Tampa area helped him stay out of trouble with the law and his old former friends and cohorts he would get away from in Howard Beach. It remains to be seen how great an easygoing, lenient sentencing Judge Block thinks things have turned out when Borrello, who's looking for a pass, faces the music. So, Gene, Judge Block gave you an opportunity to go to Florida and get your stuff together. Okay. And then I put up a story yesterday or 2 days ago stating that what the court wrote about you going into court. And now you're telling these other shows to attack me because I'm ratting on you. No, I'm not ratting on you, Gene. This is actual stuff. This is actually out in the public. Now, once Jerry Capeci puts it out there, he works for Gangland and the Daily News. He's a million times bigger than I could ever be. You would now have in your little cohorts attack me, which is fine. I don't mind that. I can handle that. They can say whatever they want about me. But see, this is the problem with the informants. When they do something wrong, they do not want to admit it's their fault. They want to blame guys like me. I have a show here. My job is to report this stuff. And Gene, that's what I did. I reported it. You know, you do not mind being in the news. You do not mind being in the podcast if it's done and said in your way. When it's not said, what you do is you try to destroy the person that's doing it. And then you have these guys that think that you're some kind of big star with these podcasts attacking me. That's not going to work, Gene. All that does is piss me off when I come at you harder with facts, not lies, Gene. I tried to help you at one time. I tried to get the judge to help you because I thought that maybe you had a chance to do well in life. But instead of doing well in life, you did bad. And like people that do bad, you're trying to blame others for your faults. It's your fault. Anything I've done in my life, Gene, and I've done a lot of bad things in my life, not the stuff that you do, not violence toward people. But the things I've done in my life, I've done them. It's my fault. And maybe when you could say that to yourself, that, look, I did these things. It's my fault. Then maybe you're going to get somewhere and accomplish things. You're 37, 38 years old. Now's the time. But if you think that you're going to bully me and provoke me by using these other guys, it ain't going to work. It's not going to work. All it's going to do is piss me off, Gene. I wrote you a little letter today, a little email. I hope you read it, Gene. Okay? I don't want to be your enemy, Gene, but if you have people doing attacking me with bullshit and lies and threatening me, what you're doing, I'm holding you responsible. You came on here and you threatened me physically. You threatened me. You lied. You said that I called your probation officer, which is a lie. Never did that. And you know I didn't do that. But you were so angry that you had to put this out there. And that ass clown's going to go along with it and put it up there because they like that idea. That's what it comes down to, Gene. And one other thing, Casparosa. all of a sudden, what are you, buddies with Gene now? I thought you were a journalist. And when someone talks to you about things, this is what a proper journalist does, Chris Casparosa. Your word to the person you're talking to as a journalist is between you and that person. But you broke that. You broke that. Now you're putting your shit out there. You know, you're mad at people, so you're going to divulge conversations you have with those people. But I promise you what, Chris Casparosa, I won't divulge any of our conversations because I'm not like you. And with that, people, I like to say thank you very much. Please like and sub this video. And guys, do whatever you want because all you're doing is pissing me off. I'm not going to go after the podcasters because you guys ain't worth my effort of time. Gene, you are. Take care, people.